Hey, what's up everybody? Tech Checker here, and welcome to episode 15 of This Week in Diorama Season 2. Now, if you are not familiar with how the show operates, every week I go through Instagram looking for the coolest looking dioramas, and I showcase them right here on the show. Now, if you'd like to be showcased in a future episode, all you need to do is upload your diorama pictures to Instagram and tag them with the hashtag This Week in Dioramas. Also, if you missed the live stream of the This Week in Dioramas Collection Challenge, Make sure that you go check that out right now. It is live and on YouTube. I'll put a link in the description below. Are you looking for a great place to get your toys and collectibles? Well, go check out Nate's Toys and Collectibles on Facebook. Link will be in the description below. If you're not familiar with who Nathan Simmons is, go check him out on YouTube at Nathan Simmons. I'll leave a link in the description below for that as well. He does amazing toy hunts and always has amazing unboxings. It is insane the amount of cool stuff that he brings home and shares with all of us. Again, go to Nate's Toys and Collectibles on Facebook, and he on a regular basis is updating, letting us know when there's pre-orders of different items. But if there's something that you're looking for that you're not seeing in his posts, just send him a note. He can usually find most anything that you're looking for. So again, go to Nate's Toys and Collectibles on Facebook and give them a follow there, and also make sure that you are subscribed to his YouTube channel as well. He's a great guy. I've done business with him several times. I've known him for several years now. He is one of the best guys in the toy community. So go to Nate's Toys and Collectibles now. Before we get started, we do need to reveal the winner of last week's fan vote. And your winner, coming in with a commanding lead, the Resident Evil Dio by Vasco Toys. Congratulations, you will now be entered into the Grand Championship vote at the end of the year. Make sure that you stay tuned till the end of this episode, where you'll get another chance to vote for your favorite on the community tab on my channel. All right, we're gonna go ahead and get started with the showcase. I am gonna apologize up front. We do have some work going on upstairs, so there may be some banging and whatnot, some sanders going. So hopefully it won't be too much of a distraction. Maybe we can get this recorded quickly enough that we'll kind of miss some of that noise. So let's get started first with Rogue.al with this really cool looking diorama. This is part of the Millennium Falcon, scratch built. You've got Harrison Ford, Han Solo right there, and I really am digging this piece. It's so clean, it looks so good, and it really brings me back to the movies. These little, I don't even know if these, somebody tell me who knows more about Star Wars. Are these things that are in the walls, do you think these are pads so that if you were to run into the wall it wouldn't hurt, or is it just a design thing that you think George Lucas, that would be cool? I don't know. I've always wondered that, but this thing looks so good, and it is such a well put together piece. I just really dig on it, so great job to Rogue. This next one is a really impressive looking piece coming from Captain Ears or Capped Ears. What do we got? Quick phone shot. I wish my phone would take good shots. This thing looks really nice. I love the picture. It looks so realistic. What else do we got here? Fine color combination for the hallway, blah, blah, blah. Anyway, this thing looks so great. I love the details. It looks so absolutely realistic. You've got the heat registers here, the prop of the bucket and the little sign, awesome. Ceiling fans, everything just looks so amazing. And then check this out. We've got a stairway, and this crack is absolutely amazing. I would have thought that this was a legitimate real apartment complex or whatever, because it looks so absolutely real. It is insane, the paintwork on here. Just look at that, the weathering on these pipes. This looks amazing. And there's more, there's another room. Good Lord, this is absolutely epic. Just dig it so much. I would love to see a full-on wide shot just to get a perspective of this thing and how big it is and how much there is to it, because it's really good. Next, coming from Crashbox Customs, your Grand Champion from 2019. coming with this massive Mythic Legions piece. It is huge, shipping it today. This thing is massive, and the paintwork on here is absolutely amazing. Look at the weathering that they've got going on here. It is so incredible. I'm amazed by this piece. It is so epic and so big. I just really dig it. Let's see, batch two of Mythic pieces. So the question that I have, because I'm only seeing these three shots, I'm wondering, is this one wall or are these three pieces that you just stacked on for the sake of being able to have that look? But normally these would be one wall. This is a wall and then this is a wall. Just really interested to know, because it's really cool. Next, coming from Fernando Rojas, always does amazing work. And again, the realism on this thing is so good. Just look at the brickwork, and then it's got kind of like a outer covering that is it's like a stucco or whatever, and you can just barely see the brick underneath, and it's wow. I just love it. The paintwork on here is so realistic looking. I mean, just look at the stone, the concrete here. That is really good. I've never gotten my concrete to look this good and this realistic. So I am always amazed by your work. I love the lights and then the hanging cables to really give this kind of an abandoned, like it's been around for a long time kind of look. And it's just, you always really just nail it. Look at that. Look at the details here on this conduit there. That is amazing. I really love it. So great work again to Fernando Rojas. Next up, coming from Christoph Customs, and you submitted several pieces, and this one I picked out from that. I really dig this piece a lot. This is a custom NECA Escape from New York diorama. And this thing is really quite impressive. I love all of the stuff that you've got going on here. Just a lot of fun detail. And the thing that I like the most is just how thematic it is and how put together it is. It's just a great piece that would look amazing on a shelf. And it would look like the manufacturer actually made this. And that is what I really dig about this piece, because there's so much cool stuff going on in this small little space. So many details. Really nice paint, great sculpt, so really nicely done. Here is an opportunity for you to win a diorama. Go to El Chombo NYC's YouTube. He's got a 700 subscriber giveaway. Make sure that you follow any and all rules. Make sure you're subscribed to him, and make sure that you are, like I said, following all of his rules to be able to get entered, and you can win this diorama that he created. And it's just a nice little stairway set that you can pretty much display anything that you would like on here. It's a really nicely done piece. So make sure that you go support El Chombo NYC. Give him a like, a follow on Instagram, and also help him to get up to 1,000 subscribers on YouTube in his 700 subscriber YouTube giveaway. Next is coming from Diorama Boy, and oh my goodness, this thing is massive. This is a 1/12 scale diorama. 8 wall pieces, 4 base pieces. My gosh, this thing is massive. It is an indoor skate park, and wow, this is so epic. I absolutely love it. I'm sure all of these wall pieces can probably come off to get you a little bit more room so you can take some really epic shots of some action poses with your figures doing some really cool tricks. This is a really cool piece, and the paintwork on here is awesome. I absolutely love it. You've got it tagged top to bottom with graffiti and whatnot. There's props and what have you, and everything looks so good. And it just, wow, you've got some lights on here to give it that underground look. It could almost be a underpass underneath a highway, or it could actually just be inside somewhere. So really, really nice piece. This one's coming from Monarch Diorama 85. It is a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles lair, and this thing is really nicely done. I love all of the details that you've got on here with the conduit, the pipes, the wires, all of that sort of stuff. You've got some little artwork on here as well, and some signage, which is really cool. Really digging on this piece. This floor section here is really nice. It's like a grate, a really big grate, which really adds to the look of this piece. So I really dig it. I'm really glad to be able to showcase it. Next, coming from Mighty Matlock. Now this thing is really cool looking. I'm not real familiar with the BioShock game. I'm not a video gamer or anything like that, but I do really dig this piece. It is kind of one of those, what do you call it? I can't think of the word. Anyway, I can't think. It's the hammering. Someone's got to stop the hammering.
Stop the hammering.
But I really am impressed with this piece. I love all of the sheets of paper that you've got up here. They really look realistic. And then you've got the Would you kindly kill whoever it is? Again, I don't know anything about the title, but it is super cool. Really nice floor on here. You just did a really nice job on this piece, and it is gonna look awesome on a shelf. Next is coming from Seething Customs, and this is a new subway station diorama, 16 inches long, 10 inches deep, and 10 inches tall. Really nice size, and this thing looks so good. You really nailed this piece. It is really looking very nice. These tiles are looking awesome. There's a little bit of a shine to them, which this kind of tile definitely has that shine. So one of the things that I'm thinking about trying to get into is playing a little bit more with some gloss or semi-gloss finishes to really add to the realism of some of the pieces. And I don't know if you truly did that on purpose or not, but that little bit of a shine that you've got here and up here is really giving it that that subway tile look, which I really, really appreciate. And the fact that you've got lights in here so that you can really get that ambiance of the scene is super cool. The paintwork is so nice. You got some little bit of weathering up here, which is great, and then these the actual map and other posters are also looking really good. So you did a very, very good job on this piece. Next, coming from Less, I'm not sure, and I can't. Oh! Thank you. You translated it. This is awesome. Good evening. Did your weekend go well? Mine, thus far has. Here's an achievement by our friend. I'm not going to be able to pronounce that. I apologize. But this diorama is very much cool, and I really dig this piece. I know that Rhino Dioramas has a diorama that you can get that is very similar in style to this from this scene. He also has a 1/6 scale. This thing really turned out nice. You did a very good job. Whomever Latelier Elderbarion. That I didn't do a very good job with that. Man, it sounds like they're hammering.
Where's
right above
the hammer?
Me. I might have to take a break for a second. But so I apologize if I'm not as crisp as I usually am when I'm doing these. We'll do our best though. The thing that I really dig about this piece is the paintwork. You did a very nice job with your paint. The weathering and whatnot looks really good. Really digging the fact that you've got some rebar or something poking out of the bottom here, which adds a lot of, realism that really adds to it. Really digging on this piece. So very, very nice job. All right, there's a lull in the hammering, so let's keep going. We've got this one coming from the Chris Lyons. This is a sewer diorama, and this is so cleanly done. His work is always really quite amazing. The thing that really impresses me the most is the weathering that you've got on, I'm not sure if this is like a door or what it is, but the rust work on there is really nice, and same with this green door as well. The weathering on there is really really good. The pipe looks awesome. Everything on here just looks awesome. I mean, obviously, this is going to be amazing for some turtles. Wow, it's so cool. The size of this thing is pretty darn impressive. So awesome job to the Chris Lyons. It always does amazing work. This one is coming from Oilers Workshop, and I had to do a double take at first because I thought this was just like some place that out in the real world that he took a picture, until I saw the key right there, and then I was like, oh my gosh, this thing is so realistic looking. I showed my wife, she looked at it, and she's like, whoa, holy cow, who would make a key so big? And I mean, this is such great work. Absolutely love it, and the fact that you took this outside and got the scale with the sky for the picture, it's just awesome. Amazing work, as always. This one's coming from RawMel1014, a really nice looking diorama. It's a commission build. The thing that really impresses me is the damage on this door. That is really nicely done. I think you did a great job with this. Your brickwork is on point, looking really nice with the mortar and what have you. And then the stencil painted sign with the liquors and whatever else is up above there. Really, really solid looking piece. You just nailed it. And whoever the customer is that's going to be taking this home is definitely going to be happy. The roll-up door actually goes up, so you must have an alternate door that is not broken, which is a really nice feature to be able to add for the customer to be able to choose how they want to take some different shots and whatnot. So awesome job on a really, really nicely done piece. This one's coming from Figures and Photography. This thing is up for sale, so hit them up in the DMs if this is something you're interested in. Obviously, it's a Batman display piece, and I am really digging this. The paintwork on here is very impressive. Your concrete looks so good, and the paint is really well done. I really dig what you've got going on here with the cracks and what have you. And then a couple of little newspapers on here really add to it. And check this out. We've got a little pipe here with a little shutoff round valve. Really nicely done. Look at that paint job on there. That is very well done. You did a great job with that. So awesome job on a really, really nice looking piece. This one is coming from DB Dioramas, and I gotta say, you really nailed this piece. I saw this and I'm like, this is really well done, and I really dig this sign. The weathering on here is very, very nicely done. It just looks really good. Like it is, you know, it's some abandoned road that hasn't been seen in a long time. You really just did a great job. And this is the perfect figure for this kind of display. It just, yeah, you just did a really nice job. The street pavement looks great. The rocks are looking really nice. This is gonna be a great display piece for your new Mezco figure. Next up from Kakaroto510, this is Kid Goku Be Wilding. I don't recall, I mean, I've never seen Dragon Ball or anything like that. Not so sure that he uses that kind of language, but you know, we're all adults here, so we can get past that, I think. I really dig this piece. It's very nice. It's kind of got that whimsical feel of a cartoon that I really dig. Again, I don't know enough about the actual property to know what's going on here, aside from he's using some sort of a log as a wheel to run and blah, blah, blah. And I love the way that this looks. The paintwork on here is really nice. You even got the rings of the tree, which is a really nice touch. The tree in the background also looks really good. So great job on this piece. This one's coming from Time Capsule Scratch Builder, and again, we've got another Book Nook. I don't know, this is the month of the Book Nook. Didn't know April was a Book Nook kind of month, but it is. This is like the third or fourth one now, and they've all been great, and this one also is a really cool looking piece. It's a Woodland Fairy Door Book Nook commission, and this thing is looking awesome. It's designed for a child to enjoy, but you know what? Child or adult, we're all children at heart, and this thing is super cool, really fun. I think there's a light underneath. Because there's a light in the window, which is a really nice touch. That is super cool. There's great details. Look at these little mushrooms. That is so awesome. I really love it. The door opens. It's just a fun little piece. You know what would be cool to go with this? Not only woodland fairies or whatever, but Smurfs. Smurfs would be great. I would love it if we could get some like 1/10, 1/12 scale Smurfs that are actually articulated. But just check out this piece. It is super cool. They've got I think they said in here that it could be used as a tooth fairy slot as well, which is kind of a cool idea. I really dig this. So awesome job on a really unique piece. This next piece coming from Dagobah Customs. I'm thinking that this is a accessory of some sort, like a storage crate or something. I think it's called a 1/12 Kaiba crystal crate, and you can DM them. I'm sure they'll have information as to how you can buy something like this. So hit up Dagobah Customs. The thing that I really like about this thing, it's obviously 3D printed, is the paint apps on here are amazing. I mean, this is so realistic looking. It's such a great looking piece. So just if this is something that you are interested in, hit up Dagobah Customs. They do a lot of really cool stuff, so check them out. This one's coming from Bryman XL. I think that we're gonna go with that. They just finished up their Cantina diorama, obviously Star Wars, and this thing is looking very nice. I really dig the arch that you've got here. The nice lighting tone also is really looking cool. And then this little grate here gives a little bit of different texture, which is kind of a fun addition to the piece. So really nicely done. The interior here is looking very cool. So I think you did a great job on this piece. This one's coming from Badger Dio, and this is a really good size piece. It's kind of like a sewer dio, and then you've got a bit of an upper portion. This reservoir or whatever is really looking cool. There's a lot of places that you can put your figures. Great display piece. I wonder, so it's 1/12 scale TMHT. TMHT. I wonder if that was supposed to be an N. Anyway, sewer dio sold already, so I apologize. You're not going to be able to get this, but hit them up in the DMs if this is something that you're interested in, because I'm sure they would be able to commission something for you. Really digging on the water effect. That motion that you got in there is really looking good, where you've kind of tipped the edges with a little bit of a white dry brush or whatever, and that is looking very impressive. So very nicely done. This one's coming from W. Collins Customs, another sewer dio. This thing looks really cool. This one is essentially a drained sewer, so we don't have the water effect. So that gives you some options to be able to throw a little bit more debris in there, or some other effects, or even use it as like a half pipe for the turtles or whatever. And I'm really digging on this piece. You did a very nice job on it. It looks really, really good. And yeah, you've got your turtles in here looking awesome. Fully collapsible, always like to see that, so great job. This one is coming from Saint Seiya Squad, and this is not certain. I think this is Yoden. I've seen their Facebook page. They do some pretty amazing work, and the Saint Seiya Squad is sharing their work. The sculpt work on here, the paint work is amazing. It is absolutely phenomenal. Just check all of this out. It looks like it's a painting on a canvas almost, the way that this looks. It's so cool looking. And just check that out. It's wow. That is absolutely amazing. I don't know how you get this effect. That it just looks like it's a painting on a wall. So great work on this piece. It is very, very impressive. This one's coming from Mighty Kane. Posted a couple of cool sets of pictures, and this one I really dig. It is Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, and then we've got Gollum in here. But we're here for the diorama, and I'm really digging on this diorama as well. The water effect looks really nice. I really dig that kind of greenish tint that you've got there. And they've got a couple more pictures, and then here's a wider shot of the actual diorama. Dio is looking really good here in this shot as well. Lots of cool details, really nice sculpt. Paintwork seems to be looking really nice as well. The lighting makes it harder to see the paintwork, but that's okay because this shot is really cool. This one's coming from 112 Community, and the diorama is actually made by Dagobah Customs. We already talked about them. I just really like this diorama piece and the picture that was taken by 112 Community. I'm pretty sure they took this picture. It is really cool looking. And what do we got in here? If you go to Dagobah Customs, they've got a code Eye of Uatu for 10% off your cart. So go check that out for more details. This picture is looking really awesome, but look at this diorama. Just a small little diorama like that, and you throw a little background in there and it is looking super cool. So go check out 112 Community for more of the information as to how you might be able to pick something like this up. This one's coming from Waka's Bazaar, and I really like this piece, and I really like the neon light that you've got here with the Waka, and it just, it's such a fun looking piece. He's got some more pictures on his profile, so make sure that you go check him out. A lot of talent when it comes to the diorama, and just look at the sculpt work on here and the lighting. Just a fun looking piece, so go check him out. This one I thought was really cool. It's from Diorama Diaries. It's a coffee shop diorama. Let's go ahead and play the video while we talk. There's so much going on with this thing. It's so detailed and so much fun. I mean, just check out all of the stuff going on with this little piece. It's just so cool. So great looking piece, lots of talent Diorama Diaries has, always brings out some really cool stuff. I can't remember what scale this is, if it's 1/32nd or 1/64th. It's a little bit smaller scale as far as I recall. So awesome job on this little coffee shop. This one's coming from Diorama1.18, another one of those folks that does a lot of really nice work. And this little shed sort of piece is looking awesome. The paintwork on here looks so realistic. The little tin roof is awesome, and I love this little patchwork piece that you've got there. Slightly different color tone, which is also awesome. It's gonna look really, really nice put together with the rest of your work. So great job on this piece. Next up is a cool video coming from Hepburnicus. Let's see, totally forgot about this little buddy that came with their 30-minute missions mecha that they painted. This is a lot of really cool stuff. I'm not entirely certain how big this stuff is. It looks like that's matchbox car size, so like 1/64th scale. There is a lot of really cool stuff in here, and I'm guessing you painted pretty much all of this stuff, because none of this really looks like stock paint jobs. It looks really cool. It's always fun to see everybody's collections and whatnot. It was fun to see the live stream, or do the live stream the other day. If you missed it, again, like I said, go check it out on the channel, and maybe we'll do something again like that in the future. But this work that you did here is so impressive. I really dig it, so thank you for sharing. This one's coming from Tom's Dioramas. He's really stepping it up, getting some really cool paintwork, sculpt work, and this is a bunch of little props inside of a little house diorama, and it looks super cool. You've got the Nintendo here with the controller. Really cool to see this kind of detail. Let me see if there's any details about how you built it, if it's 3D printed or if it is hand sculpted. Not sure. Would love to know a little bit more about how you built this, if it was hand sculpted out of foam or wood or 3D printed. So let us know in the comments below how you built this. This one's coming from Road Trip Attic. Looks like a progress picture of garage, including interior lights. So it's some sort of car garage or something with a shop, and the progress is looking really nice on this. Can't wait to see it complete. Next, coming from Turtleboy83, I just love this picture. It's a fun looking picture. We've seen the diorama before. He's selling these little prop pieces, I believe. You can get these, and it is super cool. All these Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle toy boxes that you could get, I think. Hit him up. I can't remember if he's selling. I'm pretty sure he is. I don't know why he wouldn't be, but just check it out. This is a fun picture, just to see this, and then you got Mikey in there. Awesome, awesome, love it. And then this one coming from Marvel O'Dad, and this is a handmade Sentinel. Go check out his his profile, because there's some more work in progress pics of this. This thing is really cool. You've got Colossus underneath holding this head from the Sentinel, and this thing is looking very impressive. I really dig it, and I love the fact that there's the lights in the eyes, all the tubes and what have you. So really, really cool looking project that you did there. Next is coming from Val Wegshire. He does lots of really cool train sets and whatnot that he's got, and this is a really cool picture that we could see some light on this particular like depot piece, and then you've got like the little tower over there. There's a lot of detail in here. He does some really great paint work in this. I'm not sure if this is like HO scale or what do we got here, the four T's, the Wegshire trolley and tram transit maintenance yard. So I'm not sure what scale it is, but again, I really dig on these pieces. The paint work is always so cool. So go check out Val Wegshire. He's got a really cool display piece with all of his train set and whatnot. So go check him out. Next is coming from Display Upgrades. For sale, 1/12 scale Punisher Armory Diorama. Fits a Detolf. So if you're interested in this, hit them up. If it's not already sold, they've got it for $75 shipped. Not a bad price. Really digging on the brickwork that you've got here, and the obviously the Punisher symbol. That's a really cool touch. Haven't seen a floor like this before, and that's kind of unique. I really dig that. It's almost like a tile, maybe even like a cell shaded look to it. So I dig it. That's very unique. Haven't seen that before. And then some of the props. So go check out Display Upgrades on that piece. And then this is coming from Freda0204. I thought this picture was super cool. It does lots of really cool pictures. And like I said, this is a really neat looking picture. Love the little street piece underneath. And then I'm assuming this is Matchbox car size, maybe. But let's take a look at some of the behind the scenes. We got a rain scene, and then another rain scene with a slightly different light, and then check this out. Some Christmas lights for that little bit of light bokeh that you saw in the background, a little fence here, and then you've got the little street. So this is the behind the scenes of how that shot was made, and it is super cool. I love seeing this kind of stuff. Alrighty, there you have it, folks. I hope you enjoyed all of the dios in the showcase. I know I certainly did, and there were plenty that I wasn't able to showcase. So make sure you are following the hashtag This Week in Dioramas on Instagram so you don't miss any of the awesome dioramas that everybody is submitting. But we're not quite done yet either. We've got to reveal my top five of the week, and you'll get your chance to vote for your favorite on the community tab on my channel. And my top five are the Millennium Falcon Dio by Rogue Al, the Apartment Hallway Dio by Captain Ears, the Mythic Dio by Crashbox Customs, the Garage Dio by Fernando Rojas, and the Escape from New York Dio by Christoph's Customs. Again, make sure you go to the community tab on my channel and vote for your favorite, and I will reveal the winner next week. We have reached the end of the episode again. If you liked it, I hope you hit the like button. If you're new here, hit the subscribe button and the bell notification, and go ahead and share this out with as many people as you can that you know will like dioramas as much as you or I do. And I will see you next week.
Stop the hammering. Stop the hammering out there. Who's got a hammer? Where's the hammer? Stop the hammering. I'll go down to the floor myself and stop it. I don't care who the f*** you have to call. Stop the hammering. F***ing stupid hammering.